need to apply. Zinc sulfate. Zinc sulfate contains, you have 2 minutes to, you have 2 minutes to solve this question. Zinc sulfate contains 22.6% of zinc and 43.9% of water of crystallization. If the law of constant proportion is true, then the weight of zinc required to produce 20 gram of crystal will be. You have 2 minutes, think, apply the law of constant proportion, you will get the answer.
I'm bored of seeing you.
Okay, please mute your mic, all of you. Okay, but then. Very easy question. Percentage is given to you. You have to apply law of constant proportion. Many of you have learned this. Okay, RNR 9 students, be quiet. RNR 9, maybe it is easy for you because you have got this in Kamon test. Tanya, in last class I told you law of constant proportion.
No, sir, we didn't get it, RNR people.
Okay, because RNR 9 students, some RNR 9 students may got this thing because we discussed it. Okay. So answer for this question is, you have 10 more seconds. Okay, okay, Ashish. No, don't do this. Okay, fine. How to solve this question? Okay, 1 minute. Yes. Just a minute. I'll show it to you. Just give me 1 second. Okay, fine. So this is the first question. Zinc sulfate is given to you. Those who didn't get the answer, first we'll see the leaderboard. How many of you got the answer of this question? Then we'll come to this. Okay, so leaderboard says 38 students have done it right. So it's very easy. Very easy question. Here you can do. So here this is the question. How to do the question? Mass of zinc is given 22.6%. 22.6% is mass. Then how can you do 100 gram if you take? If you take 100 gram of zinc sulfate crystal, so in 100 gram crystal, 22.65 gram is zinc, and 43.9%. Okay, then 22.65 gram zinc. Yes. Now if you see, you have 20 gram of crystal. 20 gram of crystal you have. So in 100 gram you have 20 this. So what is the answer? 22.6 gram divided by 100 into 20. This is 4.53 gram. 4.53 gram is the correct answer. Is it clear? Okay. Moving to the next question. Okay, students, next question is, the hydrated salt Na2SO4.NH2O undergoes 59.9% loss in weight on heating and becomes anhydrous. The value of N will be, this is the question. The value of N will be, okay, this question is There is some issue, but I think you can see.
So I can't read the question.
The hydrated salt Na2SO4.NH2O undergoes 59.9% loss in weight on heating and become anhydrous. The value of N will be. Hydrated salt is losing its water. Now think, sodium is 23. If you want to know the mass, sodium is 23. I told you in last class to remember. Sulfur is 32, oxygen is 16, hydrogen is 1. Please apply the concept. I told you in last class to remember.
So the whole centimeter is going to be numericals?
Yes, but easy. These are tough numericals. Later you will have easy numericals, don't worry. Okay. So, I think it's time's up. Okay, no. So, okay, fine. Masses are given 23 is sodium, sulfur 32, oxygen 16, hydrogen 1. Those who don't know. But in last class, I told you to remember the mass. Okay, only in this question, the font is like this. In next questions, you can easily read it, okay? Okay, students. So I think it's okay, fine. Most of you have answered it right only. I'll tell you how to do this question. Na2SO4 is given to you. So you have to calculate, because you know that it is a hydrated. And anhydrous means all water molecule will go outside. Like Na2SO4.NH2O is there. It is hydrated. When you heat, all water molecule will go. That's why it is called as anhydrous. So it will form Na2SO4. Plus N water. This is anhydrous. Now you have to calculate this N value. You have to calculate this N value. So you know that percentage loss is given is 55.9%. If you calculate mass of water in hydrated salt is mass of water is 2 hydrogen. Hydrogen mass is 2.
Sir, isn't hydrated sodium sulfate basically Na2SO4.NH2?
Yes, if you know that fact, you have answered, then it's well and good. It's very good if you know that hydrated sodium salt is 10H2O. Very good, you can apply that. But if you try to go through the concept, 55.9% water is the mass of water. Water is 18 gram, so total number of water molecules are N. So 18 into N. 18 into N is the mass of water. And percentage is 55.9. So total mass of hydrated salt is mass of Na2SO4. Yeah, Na2SO4, if you calculate, 23 into 2 plus 32 plus 4 times of 16 plus 18N. It is nothing but 142 plus 18N. This is the mass of hydrated salt. Now you apply the percentage. 18N mass of water divided by 142 plus 18N into 100 is equals to 55.9. By applying this, N will come out to be 10. Is it clear to everyone? Is it clear? Don't think that it is out of your portion. In last class, I told you, you need to remember the mass of atoms. From now onwards, you need to remember 16, hydrogen mass is 1, sodium mass is 23. All these things you need to remember. And once you calculate this is the formula. This is the percentage. If anyone has any doubt, don't think that you will always get very easy questions. You need to calculate in some times. Okay, now, next question. Next is, okay, now, moving to the next one, please see the leaderboard. Okay. Okay, next question. Okay, the density of salt solution is?
So, font.
Font? Okay, fine. So, this is the question. The density of salt solution is 1.13 gram per centimeter cube at 298 Kelvin. The solution contains 17% sodium chloride. What volume of solution will contain 38.42 gram of sodium chloride? This 17% is percentage means mass of sodium chloride is 17% out of total mass of solution. I don't think this question is that tough. Okay, Grahesh, yes, I understand that I did not teach in NEFL this thing, but you can apply this here, the concept that 17% mass of sodium is the mass of NaCl solution. But I think other than NEFL, all people can do this question. And even NEFL students can also do this if they apply little bit concept. Okay, fine, you still have time. Percentage of sodium chloride is 17 out of total mass of NaCl solution. Okay, fine. Last 16 seconds.
So show all the options here, we can't see it.
Okay, fine. Now, okay, students, I think okay, it time's up. Now we'll discuss the question. Okay, most of you have done. Okay, we'll see the leaderboard after discussing the question. Okay, how to do? Question is, density is given to you. Try to understand. This is the, okay, the first three questions were tough. Don't worry, those who are not getting answer, don't worry, next questions will be easy. Okay, this is also little tough questions. Those who are not used to this type of question, I have used to solve these type of questions. The solution is 17% sodium chloride. So let's say mass of solution is 100, let's say x gram. Mass of solution is x gram. So 17% of x gram is nothing but 38.42. On solving this, x you will get 226 gram. This is the mass of solution. This you will get mass of solution. And once you get mass of solution, volume is equals to mass by density. Volume is equals to mass by density. 226 divided by 1.13. That will give you 200 centimeter cube. If anyone has any doubt, please ask. No doubts, sure. Okay, I'm moving to the next question. Okay, now the questions will be easy. I'm again telling you, I want to give you hint before the next question. I want to give hint to all of you. Mole is nothing but given mass divided by molar mass. Mole is nothing but given mass by divided by molar mass. I'm giving you one example, HCl. Chlorine mass is 35.5. I will tell you mass. Mass of each atom I will tell you only for this class, not for next class. HCl mass is 35.5, hydrogen mass is 1. Total mass is 36.5 U. This is for one molecule. 36.5 U for one molecule. For one mole, for 1 mole, it is 36.5 gram. Just remember this thing. Whatever you need for 1 mole, it is same like whatever you are getting for 1 molecule. Just replace U with G. That's it. Just replace U with G. Okay? So, I am asking you very easy questions.
So, 36.5 is for which element?
36.5 gram is for 1 mole of HCl. 1 mole of HCl has this much of gram. Because 1 molecule of HCl is this much of U. 1 molecule of HCl has this much of U gram. 36.5 U mass. So, 1 mole, 36.5 gram. Okay? I am just giving you a simple question. H2. What is the mass of 1 mole? All of you tell me. Mass of 1 mole of H2. Because for 1 molecule it is 2U. So for 1 mole it is 2G. Last question to all of you. Last question to all of you. What is the mass of 1 molecule of O2? 1 molecule. Molecule is not in gram. Mole is in gram. Molecule is always in U. Molecule is always in U. Very good. 32 U. But mass of 1 mole of oxygen? Mass of 1 mole of oxygen is 32 gram. Very good, Tanvi. Did you understand, all of you? Did you understand this? Any doubt in this? Because in next few questions you are going to apply this concept. 1 molecule mass is in always in U. The same mass is there for 1 mole of that thing. The same mass is there for 1 mole of that thing. If someone asks, sir, what is 1 mole? It is like dozen only. 1 dozen things are having how much? 12 things. So 1 mole is nothing but 6.022 into 10 to the power 23 things. This is called as Avogadro number. Many of you know that. So, those who don't know, please remember, 1 mole is these many numbers. It is just like 1 dozen. Okay? Okay, I'll give you a hint. If don't worry, I'll keep on giving you a hint. Fine. Okay, so this is the result of last question. Now we are moving to the next one. Okay, which of the following has the largest number of atoms? 0.5 gram atoms. 0.5 gram atoms means 0.5 mole. 0.5 mole of Cu. A option is 0.5 mole. B option is copper mass is 63.5. It is given to you. Copper mass is mass of one copper atom is 63.5 U. Mass of one copper atom is 63.5 U. Yes, I know it's very easy. It's easy for many of you. 0.5 gram atoms means 0.5 mole. 0.635 gram, you need to calculate how many moles. If mass of one copper atom is 63.5 U. Okay, I feel that many of you may get wrong in this question. If you have not heard me carefully, 0.635 gram, how many moles it has, you have to calculate. Now, you need to check, because if moles are more number of atoms, like if you have a 2 dozen thing and you have 4 dozen thing, 4 dozen things definitely have more number of atoms, more number of things. Okay, we'll see the leaderboard first. Then we'll go to the solution of this question. Oh my God. Now see, students, I told you most of you will go wrong in this. Okay, students, I told you listen to me. Why you have not listened? I told you which of the following has largest number of atoms. 0.5 gram atoms. I was repeatedly saying gram atom means mole. Gram atom is a term used for moles. So it is nothing but 0.5 mole. First is nothing but 0.5 mole. First one is 0.5 mole. Gram atoms. I told three times. Gram atom is mole. Gram atom is mole. Okay. 63.5. 63.5 gram. Okay. One mole is 63.5 gram copper. Because one copper atom mass is 63.5 U. So in last class, in last example I told, one mole of copper is 63.5 gram. So how many moles are there in 0.635? How many moles are there in 0.635? Tell me fast. In B option, how many moles are there? How many moles are there in 0.635 gram? Yes, it is 63.5 is one mole. 0.01 mole. Are you getting? 0.01 mole. No. See, apply unitary method. One mole is 63.5 gram. One mole is 63.5 gram. 1 gram is 1 by 63.5 moles. 0.635 gram is 1 by 63.5 into 0.635. That is nothing but 0.01. Is it clear? Now, 0.02.
So, how is the answer not D?
Okay, they have asked you largest number of atoms. 0.5 in this is in A. In B, it is 0.01 mole. In C, 0.25 mole. And in D, you calculate using the same thing. 63.5 gram is 1 mole. So 1 gram will be 1 by 63.5. 1 by 63.5 moles. Did you understand, Ahan? Ahan, did you understand?
Yes, sir.
Okay, anyone has any doubt in any part? Anyone has any doubt in any part? See, you need to just apply this thing which I told you in last question. One mole is the same mass which you are getting for one atom in U. That's it. Any doubt? Why haven't we done this? So why have not we done this before? Okay, these are the new questions. You are not going to get always the same type of things. You need to check this. Okay? Any doubt? Okay, this thing many students know, but these are the little good questions. These were asked in competitive exams. So you need to understand how to apply the concept. Okay? Next question. Okay, Arushi, this chapter you will learn that chapter. In that chapter there are many other things. Okay, we will discuss that also. Okay, next question. Okay, total number of electrons present in 18 ml of water. One mole is, I told you, one mole is nothing but 6.022 into 10 power 23. You need to just check how many moles are there in 18 ml of water. You will get the answer. You need to check how many moles are there in 18 ml of water. Okay, how many moles of electron? Total number of electrons present. Total number of electrons.
Sir, can you read the Sir, the font is quite small.
Total number of electrons. Total number of electrons present in. Okay, fine. This is the question. Total number of electrons present in 18 ml. Original 6.02 into 10 power 23. That is the original value. Okay, those who feel. Okay, fine. So students, how to solve this question if you have these type of questions? So question is 6.02 into 10 power 23. It's, okay, fine. So now, 1 ml of water. 1 ml of water weighs 1 gram. Yes or no? Okay, tell me. 1 ml of water weighs 1 gram because density is 1 gram per ml. 18 ml of water weighs. 18 ml of water weighs. 18 ml of water weighs 18 gram. Yes or no? And we know that 18 gram water is nothing but 1 mole. 1 mole of water. So 1 mole of water you have implies, if you have 1 mole of water, so what will be the answer? 6.02 into 10 to the power 23.
Sir, but you asked how many electrons are present, so it's not the number of
okay.
It's not the atomic weight, so it has to be 10 to it's 6.02 into 10 to the power 23.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. See, it has to be.
Okay, 6.022 into 10 to the power 23 moles are there. Yes, these many moles of water. Okay, how many electrons are there in one water?
It has to be C.
10.
Huh? 10 electrons. 10. Very good.
So C is the answer, right?
Okay, answer will be C. Very
so
good.
C in is one, the answer. So I put H2O.
Can you correct it?
Okay, fine. I'll correct. Oxygen is 8 electron. All of you know this thing. Oxygen has 8 electron. Same like a proton. And hydrogen has 1 electron. So total number of hydrogen, 2 hydrogen. 2 electrons, so it is 10. 10 electrons are there. So answer will be these many moles. Because I have asked you electron, in 1 mole of water, there is only 1 mole of electron. But if there, okay, in 1 mole of water, in 1 molecule of water, 10 electrons implies in 1 mole of water, 10 mole electrons. So answer will be 6.022 into 10 power 24. Okay, answer is C. I'll correct it. Okay, answer is C. Many of you got it correct. I'll change the answer. Wait. Answer for this question is C. Okay, just give me 1 second. Okay, I'll change it in 1 minute. Okay, answer I have changed it to C. Don't worry. Answer is C. Fine. I'm again coming to the presentation. Okay. So, okay, students, now you can see my screen. Fine. Very good. Many of you got this right. It's a good thing. Okay. So here.
So C is the right answer.
Yeah, C is the right answer. Okay, fine. So now next question. How many molecules of hydrogen are there in 1 gram of hydrogen? How many molecules in 1 gram of hydrogen? Student, please think. 18 gram hydrogen has 1 mole. 18 gram hydrogen has 1 mole. So 1 gram hydrogen is having how many molecules? Sorry, 2 gram. 2 gram hydrogen. Okay, you do it by yourself. All of you know. Okay, sorry. 18 gram water. My bad, Monisha. Sorry. I thought it's water. Okay, you can do it by yourself. Yes, 2 gram.
So is it water or hydrogen?
No, water. Water. Hydrogen only. Okay, I
thought it's water.
Okay, it's hydrogen only. Okay, how many of you got it correct? 22. It's very easy question again. See how to do this. Thank you, Monisha, for correcting. This is nothing but next question is, okay, this is the question. Just a minute. Fine. How many molecules of hydrogen? Hydrogen molecule is H2. Okay, it is 2U. Yes or no for one molecule? What is for one mole? Students, tell me. For one mole H2, how much mass? For one mole H2, how much mass? All of you, please answer. For one mole H2, if one molecule is 2U, okay, 2 gram, very good. So 2 gram is 1 mole. It is nothing but 6.022 × 10³. 1 mole is 2 gram, so implies 1 gram is 6.022 × 10³ divide by 2. I'm again repeating. In my last class, I told you hydrogen has 1 U mass. If you remember, I told you, hey, okay, there is one trick. Those who don't know, hey, Lena. और बेबी बेबी अल्लाह के पास कल फिर गए. दीज आर द ओनली एटम्स हुज मास आर नॉट इक्वल टू द टू टाइम्स ऑफ देयर एटॉमिक मास. ओके, सो व्हाट इज दैट? हे लीना और बेबी अल्लाह के पास. देयर आर टू गर्ल्स, लीना एंड बेबी, दे वेंट फॉर प्रेयर. कल अल्लाह के पास कल फिर गए. इन दीज केसेस इट इज नॉट टू टाइम्स. Otherwise, I told you hydrogen mass is 1 U. So 2 hydrogen atoms are there, so 2 U. So mass of one molecule is 2 U. And I told you one concept. Whenever someone asks you the mole, just put the same value with gram. With gram. Okay, so 2 gram. And 1 mole is nothing but 6.022 × 10³. Implies 1 gram is this much molecules. Any doubt? Okay, this is a trick to remember, like which all atoms are not having mass equal to the two times of their atomic number. Is it clear? Okay. Next question.
Agar of mute.
Okay, no. Okay, students. Now we are moving to the next question. Total number of moles of sodium oxide in 620 gram of it. Those who don't know mass of sodium for them, okay, I know this is easy for many of you, but sodium mass is 23, oxygen mass is 16. Now do it. Sodium mass is 23, oxygen mass is 16. What happened, Rudra, Aditya? How it has taken all your points? Okay, it happened with you, I think. Anyone else has faced the same issue? Okay, students. So, number of moles. I think this time you will get correct answer. Those who are making mistakes in these questions, we'll see the leaderboard first. Okay, most of you got it right. How to do this? Okay, so. This is the question. Sodium oxide, Na2O. First, you need to know that formula of sodium oxide is Na2O. Because oxygen is 2 minus, sodium is plus 1. So, formula is Na2O. Once you get the formula of sodium oxide, 23 is mass of sodium atom. There are 2 sodium atoms. 2 into 23. Mass of oxygen is 16. So, it is 23 into 2 plus 16, that is 46 plus 16. Yes or no? So like that. Now you have 620 gram, it is nothing but it is 62 U. One molecule of Na2O is 62 U. One mole of Na2O is is 62 grams. 62 gram implies 620 gram is therein. Implies 620 gram has 10 moles. Any doubt? Students, if anyone has any doubt, please ask. No? Fine. Next question. Okay. Good students, many of you are. Okay, very good part, Tarun, Jagrav. Okay, fine, next question. Please read question carefully. These are all, you can say these are all NTSC level questions. So 2 gram of oxygen contains number of atoms equals to, you have 90 seconds to solve this question. You have to check one by one option. Those who don't know mass, hydrogen is 1, hydrogen atom has 1 U, sulfur is 32 U, nitrogen is 14 U, sodium is 23 U. You can ask me anything if you have any doubt in masses, mass of any atom, I will tell you. You have time, 1 more minute, take your time and solve this question. Okay. Yes, nitrogen is 14 U, students. Nitrogen is 14 U. Yes, Shivam. Sulfur is 32. Okay, students, we'll see how to do this. First, we'll see the result. Okay, 35 of you got it right. Very good, students. Okay, we'll see how to do. Those who didn't understand this part, we'll discuss. So, question is very easy. Okay, question says... Okay, 1 minute. Yes, this is the question. 2 grams... of oxygen, not 2 gram atoms, it is 2 gram of oxygen, contains number of atoms. Okay, oxygen mass is 1 mole. 1 mole of oxygen is 16 gram. Okay, implies 2 gram is, 2 gram of oxygen is having 1/16 into 2 moles, that is 1/8 moles. 1/8 moles. So if in any case if you are getting 1/8, that will be the answer. So if you see 4 gram sulfur 1 mole is 32 gram, implies 4 gram is 1/8 mole. Yes or no? Anyone has any doubt? No? Okay, students, in next question, it is little tough, but if you understand one thing, just one thing is used, I'll tell you the volume of STP, okay? I'll help you in that question, then you will be able to solve that. Okay, let me first show you the question. Okay, good, Karun. Now, those who are not able to read the question, I will show you here. The volume of gas at STP is this. Okay, calculate the number of molecules in this. Number of molecules in this. Okay.
Just so you haven't taught us any of this.
So just consider. That's why I told you. Just consider you have moles equals to, you have moles equals to 5 into 10 power minus 12 moles. Now solve this question. 5 into 10 power minus 12 moles. Solve this question. Volume, the moles of the gas is given to you. 5 into 10 power minus 12. How to solve this? I think now it has become easy for you. Moles is given to you. You have to calculate its molecules.
So which chapter is this in the textbook?
Okay, in which textbook? There are three classes in this, in the CentAMR. In RNR 9, NEFL 9, and there is one CBSE. NEFL 9. NEFL students, you will have it on in third chapter. No, you will have it in 10th. Don't worry. In NEFL, you don't have this mole concept in detail.
Okay, sir.
So, what about
okay.
INR? So INR, what about
you will have...
textbook?
Huh? In NCRT, you will have in this chapter only. And for RNR, you have little bit idea of mole concept. If you have the moles, you will have number, you can calculate number of molecules. Like
so what mole, about RNR?
Yes, RNR students, you know, I told you little things about the moles. What is the mole? If you remember Avogadro's law. Do you remember we discussed Avogadro's law?
So not RNR, INR.
Okay, INR you will learn in this this chapter only, atoms and molecules. But after some time, it is the last thing. Okay, so moles, it is given to you 5 into 10 power minus 12 moles. So number of molecules is in one mole, something, number of molecules is 6.02 2 into 10 power 23. Because mass is not given. These many molecules.
So time's up.
Okay, yes, 1 minute. So one mole is these many molecules implies 5 into 10 power minus 12 moles is 6.022 into 10 to the power 23 into 5 into 10 to the power minus 12. This will be the answer. Is it clear? Okay, so now answer will be 3.01 into 10 power 11. There is 12. D is the answer. Okay, many of you got it right. Good students. Next question. Okay, is this Namrata from INR? Namrata, are you the same Namrata from INR or someone else?
Yes.
Okay, the number of molecules in 16 gram of methane. Number of molecules in 16 gram of methane. Calculate it. Number of molecules in 16 gram of methane. Methane, carbon mass is 12, hydrogen is 1. Now don't ask me, sir, what is methane formula? You are expected, you are supposed to know this. What is methane formula? I think most of you know.
Hydrogen is 2 AMU, right?
Hydrogen is 1 AMU, 1 hydrogen. Hydrogen molecule is 2 AMU because it is H2. Okay.
Easy.
Okay, for many of you it is easy. And okay, fine. 1 minute. Fine, how to do this? Okay, now see, 16 gram of methane. Methane is CH4. Carbon is 12. Hydrogen is 1. Total, one molecule mass is 16 U. One mole mass is 16 gram. Yes, whatever mass of one molecule is there, this is mass of one, and the answer is this. Hope you understood this. 1 mole is nothing but 6.02 10 to the power 23. Any doubt? Students, we have any doubt? Okay, fine. So, next question. Very good, students. Now, next question is in front of you. How many moles of electron weigh 1 kilogram? How many moles of electron weigh 1 kilogram? Okay, so for hint, I can tell you mass of electron is 9.1 into 10 to the power minus 31 kg. For the hint, mass of electron is 9.1 into 10 to the power 31 kg. Mass of electron 9.1 into 10 power minus 31 kg. You can solve it. Electron mass is given to you. I think it will be easy for you to answer now. How many moles of electron weigh 1 kilogram? Okay, fine. So how to do this question? Still you have some time left. Okay, students, now I'll tell you the answer. Okay, still you have 19 seconds. Students, you should see the time. That's why I have given you time so that you calculate it properly. Okay, I think it times up now. Fine. Many of you are wrong in this question. Okay, fine. I'll tell you how. One electron mass is this much. Okay. One mole electron means 6.022 into 10 to the power 23 electrons. One electron is having this much mass. Okay. So they have asked you 1 kilogram. So just apply unitary method here. 9.1 into 10 power minus 31 kg has 1 electron. Implies 1 kg has 1 by 9.1 into 10 to the power minus 31 electrons. Yes or no? Now these many electrons you have. So you have to tell the answer. So what is the answer for this? Okay. So 1 by 9.01 into 10 power minus 31. But they have asked you how many moles? How many moles they have asked? These many electrons are there. They have asked you moles. So what I can say? In 1 mole electron, these many electrons are there. So using equation 1 and 2, what can I say? 1 by 9.1 into 10 to the power minus 31 electrons are nothing but 1 by 9.1 into 10 to the power minus 31 into 1 by 6.023 into 10 to the power 23 moles. This is by equation 1 and 2. Okay, students, please ask if you have any doubt in this. Please ask. Just apply simple maths here. Any doubt, students? Any doubt, please say yes or no.
Can you explain again?
Okay, fine. 1 kg of electron is this much. 1 kg has these many electrons. Any doubt in this? In equation 1, any doubt? Because 1 electron has this much mass, applying unitary method, 1 kg of electron will have these many electrons. 1 kg of electron. Yes or no? Someone asked this question. Please tell me. Someone told me to repeat this. Tell me your name. Janvi. Oh, who?
Sir,
please tell
Gandhar.
Me who asked. Gandhar. Gandhar, these are the 1 kg of electron has these. 1 kg of electron carries these many electrons. Yes or no? And 1 mole of electron has these. 1 mole of electron has these many electrons. So you need to tell me how many moles are there. It's like you have 25 bananas. And if I ask you how many dozen are there? How many dozens of banana you have? What you will do? 25 divided by 12. Yes or no? Because in one dozen you have 12 things. Similarly, whatever I am getting, I have divided it with 6.02 into 10 power 23. Is it clear? Okay, definitely we will have this in INR class in detail. Don't worry. Don't worry because, fine. Next question. We'll discuss this in detail. Okay, fine. Next question. Which has the maximum number of atoms? Atomic mass is given to you. Atomic mass is given to you in bracket. Carbon has atomic mass 12. Carbon has atomic mass 12. Atomic mass is given in bracket. They have asked you maximum number of atoms. Maximum number of atoms. In bracket they have given atomic mass. So like aluminium is 27. Means one aluminium atom has 27 U. Go with the help of moles, you will get the answer very easily. Proceed with moles. Okay, fine. Okay, how many of you felt that this question is easy? How many of you felt that this is easy? Okay. Oh, way too easy, fine. Okay, students, I'll tell you. It's very easy question. Okay, let me see how many of you got it right. Fine, 26, not bad number. Okay, fine, see. This is the question. I told you, my dear students, carbon atomic mass is 12. So, I can say that 12 gram of carbon is nothing but 1 mole of carbon. It is nothing but 1 mole of carbon. 27 gram of aluminium is nothing but 1 mole of aluminium. 108 gram of Ag is nothing but 108 gram of Ag is nothing but 1 mole of Ag. And the last is 56 gram of iron is nothing but 1 mole of iron. I'm not getting where you people are going wrong. 1 mole of iron. So only thing is this 24 gram of carbon. Because 12 gram has 1 mole implies 24 gram will have 2 moles. Yes or no? Any doubt? Okay, Grahesh, don't worry. Don't worry. If you have, you will understand it later. If you are not getting now, I'll explain it in class. Okay, any other doubt? No doubt. Next question.
Sir, there's one more question.
Sir, this is the last one.
Yes. Yeah, tell me what is your doubt. Okay, there are total. Okay, fine. This was the last one. Oh, sorry. Oh, congratulations, Namrata. Oh, I thought there is one more question. Okay, good. Congratulations, Namrata. Okay, if anyone has any doubt, please ask now. We have 3 more minutes left. No worries, tell me if anyone has any doubt. Actually, I thought there is one more question, that's why I took it.